okay, people were having a crap in their pants about this Rickenbacker thing. Okay, the wood part is finished. I'm not doing any more. It's over with. But, hey, it's a happy goat year to everyone. This is, you know, we're the second week into the new year, and I'm already, oh, you know. So we got the magical switch. You know, we thought we were smart guys. Hey, this is the switch, right? Well, I got news for you. It's sort of like the switch, but it isn't the switch. I'll try and get the camera in the right position here and explain what went wrong. Okay, so wait a minute. I still got to collect my thoughts before I go smash myself in the head with a hammer. Yeah, so you know, the switch came today, or yesterday, I can't remember, and I sort of been looking at the schematic going, yeah, it's no point even trying to wrap your head around that until you have this switch in your hand. So I get it, and I'm going, yeah, there's a problem with the drawing, because they don't show the ground, that's the first thing. There's the body of this has a ground, so there's actually 9 terminals on there. But when we look closely at the drawing, and I'll try and goon in here a little bit for everybody. Look closely at the drawing, right? You see the little guys with arrows, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 contacts. Those are the parts that don't move. These other little guys that stick out with that thing on it, those are the parts that do move. So I started looking at the switch. And I begin to realize that something wrong with this picture. It's just, it's 2/3 there, and there's too much on one side. So we went to the internet and explored. I'll show you. So these are just really bad wiring jobs, but it is, I got a couple of them, pictorials of what that thing actually looks like. And if we compare them closely, right, what's missing from this picture? That's got a phenolic spacer. There isn't one on that side, and we've got a contact on the outside, and we're missing a whole set. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shorties and 3 long guys. I've got 4 long guys and 4 shorties. This won't work. So, this isn't the first time, you know, I've wiped my ass with $40. I don't know what to tell the guy who owns the guitar, because I can't expect him to buy this now, can I? So, once again, beginning of the year, I trust no one anymore. None. I give my trust back to the people and the humans, and I get gooched every time. No love lost, though. I don't mean to sound like an idiot about it, but I should have known better. So what I think I can do, I'll go back to the schematic after I played with this for like an hour and a half with all kinds of jumpy wires and, you know, trying to replicate this. Let's have another look. Okay, so what can probably happen, right? Like I said, I can get 2/3 of it out of this. So what I can probably do, and I think I've done some testing, just jumper wires around, I'll be able to make it do 2 out of the 3 things it was supposed to do. And you know, I gotta be honest, this is just a tone-sucking piece of shit right here. This is like, nobody uses that. So you get one position, it's the pickup and the volume control, right out the door. Another position, you get the pickup, a volume control, and the tone control. And the way it's supposed to work is you flip to the third position, and I think if I trace it, it negates the tone control, and this tone-sucking thing comes into play and you have a volume control. But I've got another bad pictogram here of the switch once again. right, where we see, if we have a look, right, that in the middle of the movie, how it's just, this is not the same switch. Not the same switch. Close. It's got the same number of things coming out the back of it. But other than that, it can't do what this switch does. So, screw this. It's going in the corner. I got some other things I can actually fix. I'll think about it again. I got some nice new pots for it. And look, I found these really nice capacitors that will be quite suitable. You know. Okay. Thanks for hanging out, guys. And if anybody really, 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 truly can find that switch, and it can't look like that switch, I might go back to Mouser and have another peek at the specs on the switch. But this ain't it. Spin it around the other way so you guys can see. It ain't it, and it couldn't be it. Somebody's going to crack off and say, oh, you can take it apart. No, you can't. You can't. Look at the other drawing closely. There's leaves in there that have contacts on both sides, so you'd have to... No, you couldn't. You couldn't. Nor would I want to. No, see, you couldn't, because that leaf has a contact, making contact on both sides. This is a totally different switch. Bink! Gouched! Again.
Well, as you can see, something is going to happen. And this guitar will make noise, but, you know, we know. We ain't never getting there. So, we're going to go there, and after noodling through that switch compared to that switch, I can make it do two things. I can make it go straight out, pick up right out to the amp, or we flip a switch and you have a tone control, and if we had the right switch, we dial in this tone sucking apparatus there. Okay, let's get some shit back in this guitar and make it make noise.
Like I said, there's hope it might do one or two things. Hopefully it'll make sound. That would be one thing. And the volume goes up and down. And then you can flip that switch right there and pretend you're actually doing something. I don't know. Guys, jeez, kill me. Right? We're pretty much as close to sound as we're ever going to get.
Okay. Here we are. Uh-oh. Tone control works. Volume control works. That's the center position. Then we go there and... Volume control works, but tone control should be shut off. Third position, which I still think, if I have a bad dream, I can noodle how to make this work. Right now, that's a kill switch. I still think there's a way I can do this, but I ain't sure yet. But now that I've got, like I said, two-thirds of it working, I could attempt to make that silly tone sucking thing, and I don't know why you'd want that. That, you're not gonna like it even when I get it working, but I'm gonna sign off on this portion of the program. Oh, this is going to be hot as snot. I'm telling you. I like it. Nice. And then to the front.
is kill switch, and to the back is straight up just volume. I love it. What could go wrong? Let's put strings on it. At least it's going to make a noise. Cheers, folks. Thanks for hanging out. There will be another part when I get this thing all back together. And like I said, I'm still going to do a, you know, I got to get the specs on this switch and look up. Like, I've looked at it a million times, but to figure out, I don't think it's possible. I don't think it's possible. Only because it don't look like that switch. It isn't that switch. It's a different switch. I made it do two things. I'm happy about that. I thought it was going to be doing it one thing and it was going in the garbage. Okay, so I quit this for a while. We're going to button it up, put this back on the guitar, clean my bench. My goodness. Oh, and they don't give you a stick with this. They just sell you the switch. That's all you get. That's all you get. Cheers, folks. Next time, what is going to happen? I don't know. What's to say? He autographed it. It's the big Lawler, son of a bitch, and I left the condom on the front. I could peel it off and then put it back on, and nobody would know. Ooh. Okay, we'll just leave that on there. Cheers. Till next time, become a patron, subscribe, Facebook group, Twitter me, you know. All the other stuff's below. Cheers.